No.
Mama, Kay.
Recording in progress.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Xin niên quay là Gong Si Fa Thai. Hare Krishna. Om Jnana Tamarandasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chaksuran Militan Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Vanchakalpatarubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Bhai Evata Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Adaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare 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 Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So we're reading Brihad Bhagavatamrita and we are hearing about Narada Muni searching for the devotees who've got the greatest mercy from Lord Krishna.
今天我们继续来聆听大伯加瓦坦甘露这部书。Narada Muni在寻找哪些奉献者从主Krishna那里获得了最大的仁慈。
So we heard how Lord Krishna had come to Dwarka, and in Dwarka, Lord Krishna was feeling the separation from the people of Vrindavan.
我们听到Narada Muni来到了Dwarka城，在那里，主Krishna正感受着跟Vrindavan人们的分离之苦。
But Lord Krishna felt it would be impossible for him to go there to Vrindavan, and to he thought if he went to Vrindavan, then the people in Vrindavan, they would never let him leave. They would always be in great anxiety about him leaving them again.
但是主 Krishna 感到他不可能去Vrindavan。 因为如果他去文达文的话，文达文的人们就会忧心忡忡，担心 Krishna 何时会再次离开文达文。So
Lord Krishna is describing the situation.
所以主 Krishna 他就描述了当时的处境。
So he's talking to Uddhava. Lord Krishna is talking to Uddhava and other devotees. He's telling them, he said he was very absorbed. I was absorbed. I was so contented. I was so comfortable, satisfied. I was so absorbed in that mood, and that at the same time I had to talk to demigods like Lord Brahma, and I had to watch them offer me prayers and offer. They were offering homage. They were honoring me. So it was very, it seemed painful. It was painful. Krishna says, I forgot the work I had to do for the demigods.
主 Krishna, 他就这时候在向乌达瓦和奉献者们说话，他告诉他们说， 我当时是全神贯注的，非常心满意足，处在一种非常舒适的心绪 当中，同时呢，我还要聆听drama 和的谈话，我在观察着他向我献上的祈祷，他献上的荣耀和赞美之词。但是我是如此的痛苦，我忘记了我要为伴神们所做的活动工作。
So sometimes, people like Indra, who is the king of heaven, and Narada Muni, who is the son of Lord Brahma, sometimes they would want to come to see Lord Krishna and to talk to him and discuss different things which were going on in the universe.
有的时候像天帝 Indra 这样的半神人，天堂之王和Brahma 的儿子 Narada 会来觐见主 Krishna， 和他谈话，讨论有关宇宙的事物。
But Krishna thought that whatever words they had to say were just a distraction from his pastimes which he was enjoying with his friends.
但是主 Krishna 认为，无论这些人说什么呢？只是在打扰他和他的朋友之间所进行的消时光。
And Krishna had actually promised to the demigods before he came to the world, he promised that he would get rid of evil kings like Kamsa.
Krishna 在降临尘世之前曾经事先答应过半神人们，他将要去除邪恶的康萨王。
He knew that kings like Kamsa were just a burden on the earth and giving trouble to the whole planet, and Krishna had made a promise that he would remove them. But when he came there, he didn't even want to think about that. He forgot about his promise.
主 Krishna 知道像 Kamsa 这样的邪恶国王对地球而言是一个打扰，给地球造成了负担，所以 Krishna 承诺说要去除这些邪恶的国王，但是一旦他降临尘世之后呢，他从事消时光，他就不去想这些事，他已经忘记了他事先的承诺了。
Krishna was so enjoying with his friends, like the gopis and the cowherd boys, that he didn't want to be bothered with all these things.
Lord Krishna, 他当时非常享受和他的朋友，勾皮牧牛同朋友们一起玩耍，他就忘记了这些承诺了。
So Krishna says that his beautiful form and his dress and the very sweet sound of his flute, that it enchanted the whole universe with love of God.
To Krishna 说他美丽的形象，他的衣衫，他甜美的鼻音，吸引了整个的宇宙，并且用神爱迷住了全宇宙的居民。
So if all the common people, the ordinary people in the world, they all got love of God, just imagine the effect it must have had, all of these things, like Krishna's flute, how it must have affected the people of Vrindavan.
倘若像世上的普通人都能够被所有上述这些事物所深深的吸引，那可想而知，文达文的人们是如何深深的受到 Krishna 的吸引。
So Krishna's beauty never reduces, even when he leaves Vrindavan to live somewhere else for more than 100 years, but his beauty never reduces.
Krishna 的美他永远不会减少，即便他离开文达文去到别的地方居住，他在世上100多年的时间，他的美从来没有减少。
But sometimes Krishna will think about the past. He will think about his childhood, and he will remember the beautiful things which happened, like during his youth.
有时候 Krishna 也会回忆起他孩提时代的时光，他有时候他也会回想过去，想起他以前年轻时候曾经进行过的那些小时光。
But Vrindavan has very special qualities. Krishna in Vrindavan is very in a very special mood.
但是
there's a special attraction between Krishna and his devotees in Vrindavan.
Vrindavan 拥有特殊的品质。在 Vrindavan 的 Krishna是与众不同的，是 Krishna 和他的奉献者之间的相互的受到深深的吸引。
So, it's only in Vrindavan that Krishna does certain things. He adds certain things to his appearance, like he puts in Vrindavan, he puts a peacock feather in his hair, and only in Vrindavan does Krishna play flute.
Krishna 只在 Vrindavan 从事着特殊的活动，他在那里，他和他的父母之间，拥有特殊的交流。他只在 Vrindavan 他才头插孔雀羽毛，他在 Vrindavan 他才吹响他的笛子。
So, Krishna's charm, his natural charm, attracts the entire world.And gives people a special taste, which is greater than all kinds of material enjoyment.
Krishna 的魅力，天然的魅力，自然然会吸引到全宇宙。它会给人们带来特殊的品味。它超越了各式各样的物质享受。
And it's millions of times more pleasure than any pleasure you could get from the happiness of the impersonal Brahman.
而且这种快乐是比非人格的 Brahman 达到非人格的 Brahman 觉悟的快乐要高上上百万倍。
And everyone in the universe can taste.The highest bliss of Vrindavan by hearing about it from Srimad Bhagavatam and other scriptures.
这个宇宙之间，每一个人都可以从圣典博伽瓦坛以及别的经典来聆听，聆听上述的这些消时光。从而得到最大的品味和最高的极乐。
So the highest bliss of Krishna consciousness can be had anywhere.
所以在任何地方都可以取得 Krishna 知觉的最高的极乐。
But still those people who live with Krishna in Vrindavan,then they associate with Krishna directly, then they're the most fortunate.
即便如此，那些居住在 Vrindavan 和主 Krishna 有着直接联谊的人们是最幸运的幸运儿。
Because they're not only hearing Krishna with their ears,But with all of their senses, they're using them in the service of Krishna.
因为他们不仅仅用双耳能够聆听到有关 Krishna 的一切，他们的感官也在直接地从事着服务 Krishna.
So the scholars of the Vedas and the pundits, the learned people, they all say that the perfection of life is to follow in the footsteps of the people of Vrindavan.
因此，那些伟大经的学者 pundit， 他们说，人生的完美境界就是追随文达文居民的足迹和步伐。
And the perfection of life comes when you were invited to become a resident in Vrindavan eternally, in the eternal abode in the spiritual world.
所以，完美境界就来自于我们受到邀请，能够成为文达文的居民，从而永恒的在灵性世界的永恒居所有一席之地。
So demigods like Brahma and Rudra, Indra and Chandra, others as well, they all move in the sky, but they were overcome by changes due to the awakening of ecstatic love.
像 Brahma, Rudra,英者、昌者、天地英者和半月神这样的半神人们，还有其他的人们，他们在天宫遨游。然而他们都因为唤醒了狂喜的神爱，所以他们身上发生着变化。
So the people of Vrindavan were so powerful, they were so much affected by the love of Krishna which they have, that they changed their nature.
Vrindavan 的人们呢，他们是非常有力量的，然后他们受到对 Krishna 的爱的影响，从而改变了本性。
Even non-living objects, which are not usually conscious, they became conscious.
那些通常是没有知觉的，没有知觉的生物，他们也变得有知觉了。
And above Vrindavan, in the sky above Vrindavan, different heavenly beings would gather there to watch what was going on.
在 Vrindavan 的上空，不同的天堂生物，不同的天堂生物体都聚集在一起，在观察着 Vrindavan。发生的事情。
Yeah, the chief demigods would be watching, and even the sages and the Gandharvas and the Vidyadharas, they would all be in the sky above, and they'd be watching everything that took place in Vrindavan.
主要的半神人，还有那些圣人们，包括还有甘达瓦歌仙、知识仙。他们都聚集在文达文的上空，观察着文达文发生的一举一动。
So not only these demigods in heaven, but all the residents of Vrindavan, they were all affected by the love of Krishna, and they changed their nature.
不仅仅是这些天空当中的半神人们，还有文达文的居民们，他们都由于对 Krishna 的爱，受到对 Krishna 的爱的影响，从而改变了本性。
Some of the demigods, they were accustomed, they would only stay in heaven, but But they were attracted to come down and to live in Vrindavan. And great demigods like Lord Brahma and other big demigods who are the wisest and the most respected and they had all kinds of knowledge, but they lost their power of discrimination and behaved like simple fools almost.
像伟大的半神人 Brahma, 还有那些大半神人们，他们本来都是聪颖异常、受人尊敬的，他们拥有着知识。但是他们却失去了分辨力，他们的行为举止就像一个简单的傻瓜。
And the cows and the other animals who used to roam in the fields, they seemed to achieve samadhi.
而那些母牛，还有其他的田野当中的动物们。他们却进入了神定状态。
Yeah, they stood still like they became like plants or like trees.
他们呆呆地站立在那里，就好像树木和植物一样。
And the plants and the trees and the bushes and things, they became like animals and they began to tremble and move about.
而那些植物、灌木和树木，它们此时却像动物一样开始浑身颤抖，四处的，浑身颤抖，而它们，移动起来。
And things which had no life, like the rivers and the lakes, they became as if they were alive, and they were overflowing with ecstasy.
那些没有生机的河流、湖泊，却变得生气勃勃起来，被狂喜所淹没。
They would sometimes they would overflow with ecstasy.And they sometimes stopped their current completely, and sometimes flowed wildly. So they were it was unpredictable what was going to happen with the river.
有的时候，他们，涌流着狂喜的波涛。这些河流，它们都充斥着这些。有的时候，它们停止了流动，那有的时候呢，它们又开始狂野的奔涌起来。
And in the sky, the winds were blowing clouds, but the clouds became fixed in one place.
在天上呢，本来是有朵朵的浮云，但是这些云却停滞在上空。
The clouds became like umbrellas, giving shade to Krishna and his devotees from the hot sun.
这些云朵变成了一把把的伞一样的，就在天上给 Krishna 遮阳，是让他避免骄阳的灼烤。
This is all described in the Srimad Bhagavatam in relation to Krishna's pastimes.
这些在圣殿博加瓦坛当中描述 Krishna 的消失光的时候都有所形容。
It said in the Srimad Bhagavatam that people are talking to Mother Yashoda, other devotees are talking to Mother Yashoda, and they're telling her, your son is expert in all the arts of herding cows.
在圣殿博加瓦坛当中，那些奉献者们对亚修达说道，您的儿子可是精通有关于放牛、照料母牛的一切技巧。
And he has developed many new ways of playing the flute.
而且您的儿子也发明了许多吹奏笛子的技巧。
And when he plays the flute in his bimba red lips, his lips are red colored due to the bimba fruit.Like the bimba fruit. So when he plays the flute, he sends the nectar, the nectarian sound of his flute in different melodies. And Brahma, Shiva, Indra, and the other demigods all become confused when they hear it.
Krishna 的嘴唇因为咀嚼冰的果而变得红润，所以当他用像冰的果般红润的嘴唇吹响笛子的时候，就发出如甘露一般的笛音。这些笛音拥有不同的曲调，使得像 Brahma、Shiva、Indra 这样的半神都被迷惑了。
Although they are the most learned authorities, they cannot understand the essence of that music which is coming from the flute of Krishna. And so they simply bow down their heads to the lotus feet of Krishna.
即便他们是最博学的权威，他们也不明白Krishna 的笛音的精髓，所以他们只能够向 Krishna 的莲花足顶礼致意。
So Lord Krishna says, you can ask Kalindi whether or not everything I'm saying is true.
Krishna 说，你们可以问卡林迪，我所说的话是不是真的。
Kalindi is the river Yamuna.
Kalindi 就是亚穆纳河。
So she had seen Krishna's pastimes with the people of Braja.
所以他目睹了 Krishna 和 Braja 居民的消失光。
So we should understand everything Krishna is speaking is true. It is, there's no exaggeration.
所以我们要明白 Krishna 所说的每一句话都是真实的，并没有夸张的成分。
And Kalindi will confirm everything Krishna is saying.
Kalindi 可以证实 Krishna 所说的一切。
Because she's there in the form of the river Yamuna.And the Yamuna is the sister of Yamaraj, who always speaks the truth. Because Yamaraj is the king of religion.
因为卡林迪就是亚穆那河，而亚穆呢是亚玛拉是阎罗王的妹妹，而阎罗王他又是真理的化身，他是宗教之王。
But Krishna says, I'm not able to allow the Yadavas to show the same emotions.
但是，就 Krishna 说，我不可能允许亚度族人们展示出同样的情感。
Krishna said, even if I joke with them or have entertaining pastimes, still I'm not able to change them.
Krishna 说，即便我和他们开玩笑，或者是上演进行逍遥时光，我也无法改变他们。
So Krishna is telling us that outside of Vrindavan is different from in Vrindavan.
So Krishna 告诉人们，在 Vrindavan 之外和 Vrindavan 是截然不同的。
And it's not just the pleasure which he enjoys in Vrindavan.There's something more than just his own pleasure.
这不仅仅是由于 Krishna 在 Vrindavan 享受的快乐的原因，除此之外，还有他自己的快乐之外的其他的原因。
And Krishna feels outside of Vrindavan, he's not able to satisfy his devotees the same.As in Vrindavan.
Krishna 感受到，在 Vrindavan 之外，是不能够像 Vrindavan 使得奉献者们感到满足，和这两件事是不能同日而语的。
So Krishna said, here in Dwarka, I found it difficult to break the pride of queens like you. Krishna's talking to Satyabhama. He said, here in Dwarka, I find it difficult to break the pride, kind of pride which you have.
Krishna 对 Satyabhama 说，在 Dwarka,很难打破你这样的皇后的骄傲。
When Krishna's in Dwarka, he talks intimately and jokes with his wives and friends and advisors.
在 Dwarka, 就 Krishna 和他的妻子、朋友、顾问们会开玩笑。
And Krishna enjoys things like water sports and other pastimes with the queens and other ladies there.
他在多尔卡也会和皇后们还有那里的女士们享受水枪这样的游戏。
But the feeling that he gets outside of Vrindavan is not like the feeling in Vrindavan.
在 Vrindavan 之外所获得的感受和在 Vrindavan 所获得的感受是不一样的。
Yeah, in Vrindavan, outside Vrindavan, people always show so much reverence for Krishna.They're showing so much respect for him from the devotees. So he never feels the same kind of freedom as he does in Vrindavan.
在 Vrindavan 之外的人们， Vrindavan 之外的奉献者们对主 Krishna 总是怀着敬畏，彬彬有礼。所以主 Krishna 不像主 Krishna 在 Vrindavan 那样感到非常自由自在。
In Dwarka, of course, Krishna has all of his queens there. So sometimes the queens will behave jealously with each other. They're like, they may jealous another woman, another queen more than themselves.
在 Dwarka, 主 Krishna 的皇后们彼此之间会有嫉妒，他们会感觉到另外一位皇后要胜过自己。
So although they become jealous, they actually never become opposed to Krishna, and they're always servants surrendered to Krishna and want to please Krishna.
尽管他们有着嫉妒，但是他们永远从来不会反对 Krishna。他们总是就像女仆那样臣服 Krishna， 想要取悦他。
So it's not difficult for Krishna to control their pride. To control the pride of the queens is not difficult for him.Because the queens all want to please Krishna.
对 Krishna 而言，要控制这些公主的骄傲是不难的，因为这些公主们都想纷纷的想要取悦 Krishna.
But in Dwarka, Krishna can't do the kind of things which he would do in Vrindavan.
但是在 Dwarka, Krishna 是不能就像他在 Krishna 在 Dwarka 不能去做他在 Vrindavan 所从事的事情。
One of the things is that he says in Dwarka, Krishna says he feels ashamed to play the flute.
Krishna 说他在 Dwarka 是很难为情去吹笛子的。
He's concerned that people may laugh at him if he plays the flute in Dwarka.
他担心自己在 Dwarka 吹笛子会招人们的嘲笑。
And in Dwarka, he no longer feels the inspiration to create that same music which he does in Vrindavan.
在 Dwarka, 主 Krishna 也没有这样的心情想要去创造他在 Vrindavan 所创作谱写的那些音乐。
So how much it depends on the environment which Krishna is in. According to the environment, Krishna will display his different opulences, his different qualities accordingly.
所以要取决于 Krishna 所处的环境， Krishna 会相应的展示他不同的富裕和品质。
So Krishna says, oh, he said, what I did and how I lived in Vrindavan, it seems so different now. I'm so far away now that I'm with youI cannot even speak about those things which I did in Vrindavan.
Krishna 说，哦，我 我在 Vrindavan 所做的，以及我是如何在 Vrindavan 居住的，现在看上去是那么的不同，我离那里是那么的遥远，我甚至都无法和你们谈论起 Vrindavan。
Krishna is all powerful, and he knows everything, he can do everything. In any circumstance, he can do anything. So he should be able to take on any appearance and act as he likes. Even if he's in Dwarka or anywhere else.
Krishna 是最有力量的，他知悉一切，他无所不知，所以本来 Krishna 是可以以任何的形象显现在任何的地方，或者是去做他想要做的一切，无论是在多尔卡还在别的地方。
So Krishna should be able to take on, he should be able to take any form he likes. He should be able to make his life in Dwarka just as it was in Vrindavan.
Krishna 本来是可以就显现为任何的模样，也可以把他在多尔卡的生活就变得和文达文的生活一样。
But Krishna's desire changes according to the atmosphere in which he's living. So when he lives in Dwarka, he has different mood, different desire from when he's in Vrindavan.
但是 Krishna 的愿望会根据他生活的氛围而改变，所以 Krishna 在 Dwarka 他会以他在 Dwarka 的心绪而生活。
When he's outside of Vrindavan, he's less inspired to show his feelings so freely, which he does in Vrindavan.
在 Vrindavan 之外 Krishna 就没有这种冲动去展示他在 Vrindavan 所展示出来的这种心绪。
Yeah, in Dwarka, he cannot do the same pastimes of his childhood, which gave him so much pleasure.
在 Dwarka, Krishna 就不能去做他孩提时代的那些逍遥时光，而这些孩提时代的逍遥时光给他带来如此巨大的快乐。
And he cannot surround himself he cannot surround himself with all his gopis and the other Brijbasis. When he's in Dwarka, he cannot bring all these people with him to Dwarka.
当主 Krishna 在 Dwarka 的时候呢，他也不能把 gopi 和 Brijbasi带到多尔卡，让他们围绕着自己的身边。
The environment in Dwarka is so different to the intimate mood of Vrindavan that he cannot even talk about it with the people in Dwarka.
在多尔卡的环境是如此的迥异， 就所以和他在 Vrindavan 的这种亲密的情感是完全不一样的，他甚至都无法谈论 Vrindavan。
He can't talk about his childhood.
他无法谈论自己的孩提时代。
And if he was to speak about these things with the people of Dwarka, then if he was to speak directly about it, the people of Dwarka would become lost in trance and they'd be unable to continue their own service.
如果他和 Dwarka 的居民直接的讲述文达文的事情，多尔卡的人们就会进入到神定当中，不能继续自己的服务
了。Just one person.Almost as dear to Krishna as the devotees of Vrindavan would be able to describe these topics. And that person is Sukadev, the son of Vyasadev.
只有一个人对 Krishna 非常至亲至爱的人，能够谈论 Vrindavan 的奉献者，谈论 Vrindavan 的话题，这个人就是 Vyasa Dev 的儿子 Sukadev Goswami。
Yeah, so because of his, because he has the mood of the Brijbasi people, and he has the same kind of love which they have, so he can speak something of these matters.
因为他和 Brijbasi 的居民们有着同样的心绪和爱，因此他可以谈论这些小时光。
And when he will speak about these things, then it will help his disciples. It will be relishable by his.
如果他讲述的开口讲述，这将帮助他的门徒去津津有味的去品味这些小时光。
And Lord Krishna says that these disciples, that his disciple is like him in spiritual qualities.And I once brought them back to life.
Mr. Krishna 说，他的 Sukadev Goswami 的门徒们和他拥有同样的灵性品质，所以我想令他们充满着生气。
So we should understand.If nobody ever hears about Krishna's Vrindavan pastimes, then how will Krishna fulfill the main purpose of his purpose in coming to this world, which was to spread to the world about the nature of Prema Bhakti?
倘若没有人听说过 Vrindavan 的小时光，不明白，那么 Krishna 就无法实现他降临尘世的目的，也就是在世上传播 Prema Bhakti 的本质。
So Krishna is telling us that this, the glory the nature of this prema ras, which is there in Vrindavan, will be revealed when Sukadeva Goswami speaks the Srimad Bhagavatam to Maharaj Parikshit.
Krishna 告诉我们 prema ras 的本质，在 Vrindavan 的 prema ras 的本质，当 Sukadeva Goswami 向 Parikshit Maharaj 在圣田国家把坛当中予以揭示的时候，那 prema ras 的本质就会被揭示出来。
And Sukadev's own devotion is very close to the people of Vrindavan. It's on the same level of the people of Vrindavan. So he has the power to describe the glory of Vrindavan.
由于 Sukadev 的他自身的奉爱之情非常接近 Vrindavan 的居民，处在同一的层面上，所以他有力量来描述 Vrindavan 的荣耀。
And even the glimpse of that Krishna Bhakti that Sukadev will reveal in the Bhagavatam, that will be enough to give to any human being who hears honestly. Anybody who hears carefully and seriously this message of the Bhagavatam, then they will get the highest taste of pure devotion. So Sukadeva Goswami will speak the Srimad Bhagavatam to the most suitable person, who is Maharaj Parikshit.
因此 Sukadeva Goswami 将向最合适的人选，也就是 Maharaj Parikshit 大君讲述圣典不教瓦坛。
And it was Maharaj Parikshit who Krishna brought back to life when he was in the womb of his mother.
正是这位Parikshit Maharaj, 就是 Krishna 在 Parikshit Maharaj 在他母亲的子宫当中，他使他起死复生。
Yeah, in the Mahabharata, it tells that actually when Ashwatthama threw the Brahmastra weapon, he actually killed Maharaj Parikshit. He killed the baby in the womb. But Krishna entered the womb and gave the baby a new body.
在马哈巴尔特这部书当中描述说，阿什瓦塔玛用他的反射光武器 Brahmastra 杀死了海尔 Parikshit。然而这 Krishna 就进入了子宫，给了他一个新的躯体。
So Maharaj Parikshit became Krishna Jivita, means Krishna brought him back to life.
所以 Parikshit Maharaj 就成为了 Parikshit Pachita, Jivita, 也就是说 Krishna 使他起死回生，给了他一个新的生命。
And every moment of his life was dedicated to remembering Krishna.
Parikshit Maharaj 的生活的生命的每一时刻都奉献于冥想，记忆 Krishna。
So Parikshit Maharaj was a perfect Vaishnava like his guru Sukadev.
因此 Parikshit Maharaj 是就是一位像他的 Guru 一样完美的 Vaishnava。
So Sukadev could speak to him the most confidential topics.
因此 Sukadev Goswami 可以向他讲述这最机密的体旨。
But the combined efforts, although you have the most qualified speaker and the most qualified hearer, Srimad Bhagavatam can distribute the light even in this blind age of Kali. By the combination of these two great souls, the Sukadeva Goswami, the most qualified speaker,And the most qualified hearer, Maharaj Parikshit. So this way Srimad Bhagavatam could give the light to this dark age of Kali.
通过最有资格的讲述者 Sukadeva Goswami 以及最有资格的聆听者 Parikshit Maharaj 这二者合在一起的努力，那么圣典博加瓦坛得以给予这个黑暗的卡利年代带来光明。
All right, so we'll stop here today.
好，那我们正课部分就讲到这里，接下来我们是回答问题的时间。啊，我们看，先看第一个有关的问题是 GND。他说感谢敬爱的 Maharaj， 感谢大家，不是说文大文的一切本来都是有生命的而且有人格性的吗？为什么 Guru 刚才说一些本来没有知觉的河流云朵等等听到 Krishna 的笛音才发生了变化？ Thank you dear Maharaj and devotees. Isn't that Everything in Vrindavan is alive and is personified. But in your lecture, Guru said that the unconscious river and cloud, after hearing Krishna's flute, the sound of flute, they changed.
Yes.So, we have to understand that the sound of Krishna's flute changed everything. So the river usually is not conscious. It's not, you say everything is conscious. That's in the spiritual world, but we're talking about in the material world.In Vrindavan and Gokula, not Goloka, we're talking about Gokula, which is on the material planet Earth. So the river Yamuna is different. In the spiritual world, everything is fully conscious. But in this world, it's different.
是的 ,Krishna 的笛音可以改变一切。一般来说河流是没有知觉的，那么我们要明白在灵性世界和物质世界是不一样的，我们在这里谈论的是 Gokula 的 Vrindavan 是在物质星球物质的星球地球上，在灵性世界它是有知觉的，但是在这个世界上是不一样的。
But when Krishna appears there in Vrindavan and plays the flute, then everything changes.
但是当 Krishna 显现在 Vrindavan 吹笛子的时候，一切就改变了。
The unconscious become conscious, and the conscious become almost unconscious. They become like in samadhi.
那些没有知觉的就变得有知觉了，而有知觉的呢， 就变得就失去了知觉，好像就进入了 samadhi 神定当中。
So you have to understand how Krishna's flute affects everyone in different ways.
所以你要明白 Krishna 的笛音是就以不同的方式影响着每一个人。下一继续问 Krishna 更享受亲密的关系而不是恭敬的关系，我们和奉献者相处中应该保持恭敬还是尽量亲密呢？怎样避免过于熟悉亲近从而失去基本的尊重？ Krishna enjoys more intimate relationship instead of warm reverence. In our dealing with devotees, how should we become very intimate with devotees or to become very respectful? How to avoid losing the basic respect and to avoid to become too intimate with them and therefore lose the basic respect for them?
Yes, you have to understand that Krishna's intimate with the devotees, that's based on pure love. Because there's pure love there, so the intimacy is very deep and very real. It's not just some sentiment, but there's a genuine love and feeling of worship, honor, and respect given to Krishna. And Krishna allows that intimacy with his very pure, very, very advanced devotees.
Krishna 在 Vrindavan 的奉献者对他是满怀纯粹的爱意，这种亲密他是发自于非常深厚的真挚的情感，而不是感情用事。这种真正的爱，它是真诚的、诚实、真心实意的，是也是出自于尊敬。所以 Krishna 便享受了他最纯粹的进步的奉献者与他的亲密情感。He's asking how to, so in our dealing with devotee, should we become very respectful to them or to become very intimate with them?
Well, you can become respectful to those who are your seniors, and you can become more intimate with those who are your equals.
您可以对您就是长辈怀着恭敬心，和平辈变得更加亲密一些。So he's asking how to avoid due to too much familiarity and therefore lose the basic respect.
Well, you have to remember how to properly deal with people. Being intimate with someone doesn't mean you're intimate, that you doesn't mean to take advantage of them and disrespect them, but it's an intimate relationship based on caring and loving.
你要记住，就是这种交往应该是正确的、恰当的方式交往， 亲密不等于要利用对方或者是不尊重对方，而是基于深深的关怀和爱意，从而有这种情感。
And the other party must be willing to have that kind of relationship with you. It's not that you can force yourself on someone.
并且对方也愿意和您建立这样一种关系，而不是单方面强加给对方。
嗯。
嗯，下一个问题 ，Hari Vansa， 在这个物质世界的文大文和灵性世界的文大文雅木的和有区别吗 ？Is there any difference between Vrindavan in this world and in the material world and the spiritual world? And is there any difference?Between Yamuna River in this material world and the spiritual world.
Yes. One's in the material world, one's in the spiritual world. So in the spiritual world, there's a difference. There's some difference, you can say that.In the spiritual world, the Yamuna is there in complete transcendental form. It's not going to be contaminated. Just like the Yamuna here on this planet, now it's very contaminated. People have put a lot of things in the Yamuna. There's a lot of poison, a lot of gas and...So much problem, so much pollution. And also the river Yamuna is becoming less and less. It used to be much deeper, much more water, but it's less and less water now. So then there's been a lot of changes with the Yamuna River here on this planet. But in the spiritual world, there's no change.
嗯，是有区别的。雅木的河它在灵性世界，它是完全超然的形象，它也不会受污染。但是在这个星球上的雅木的河呢，它是受到污染的。嗯，现在人们都往里面投放许许多多的东西，它也有那么多的毒素，有毒有害气体，还有那么多问题，有那么多的污染。现在的雅木那河呢，水量越来越少，变得越来越浅。雅木那河呢，也是在这个星球上的雅木河是变化的，而在灵性世界的雅木那河是不会变化的。
嗯，
下一个是。阿尔邦萨 ，Krishna 根据不同环境表现相应的情感，是不是也在告诉我们，也要根据环境调理自己的心态？是环境影响了 Krishna 的心态吗？连至尊主都受环境的影响，更何况我们呢 ？Krishna will reveal.Exhibit different emotion according to different atmosphere. Isn't that reminding us that we should also adjust our mood according to atmosphere? Is the atmosphere, does the atmosphere affect Krishna's mood? Even the Supreme Lord.Is affected by the environment, then what to speak of us?
Yes, you're right.
是的，您是对的。
If even Krishna is affected, then certainly we are also affected.
如果 Krishna 也受到影响，我们肯定也会受到影响的。
We're affected by the material environment. Krishna's affected by the difference between Vrindavan and Vrindavan and Dwarka. They're different. For us, we're not so much able to perceive the difference between Vrindavan and Dwarka, but we can see the difference between the holy Dham and the ordinary places in the material world.
We are affected by the material environment, and Krishna is affected by Vrindavan and Dwarka, these two places. We are not able to know the difference. We are not able to know.我们对于文达文和多尔卡这两个地方是没有那么高的觉知力的，但是我们却可以感受到圣地，就不同的圣地之间的区别。We cannot perceive the difference between Vrindavan and Dwarka, but we can distinguish between different holy dham, right?
We can distinguish between the material world and the holy dham.
Sorry, I didn't catch the meaning.
We can distinguish between the holy dham and the ordinary towns in the material world. They're not the same.
Okay. 我们是可以区别出圣地和普通的物质世界的这个世俗的城镇，他们的区别。The next 下一个问题是，仆人，顶拜孤儿的莲花族和所有奉献者，我们是受制约的灵魂。能理解 Krishna 的消失光吗？还是达到 Arjuna 层面 Krishna 才会揭示的呢？ Obeisance to Guru's lotus feet and devotees, we are conditioned soul. Can we understand the pastime of Krishna, or only we attain the level of Arjuna can Krishna reveal to us?
Well,We can understand something of the pastimes of Krishna. We cannot understand fully everything about Krishna's pastimes. But when we hear it from the proper place, from the proper people, then we can understand.
We can understand Krishna's 某些部分，但是无法完全的领会 Krishna 消失光。但是我们应该从正确，我们该在正确，从正确的地点，从正确的人们的口中聆听。
We're reading Srimad Bhagavatam from Srila Prabhupada, the words of Srila Prabhupada, so we can understand Srila Prabhupada's words.
我们是通过Srila Prabhupada的话语来理解圣典波迦瓦坛，因此我们可以明白到圣帕帕德的话语。
So, yeah, we make some efforts. We have to apply our mind and intelligence to studying Prabhupada's books, and then we can understand.
我们需要付出努力，用我们的心意和智性努力去研读圣帕帕的书籍，这样才能理解。
So Srila Prabhupada is explaining Krishna's pastimes to us. We just have to hear.
圣帕帕德，向我们解释了 Krishna 的消失光，我们只需要洗耳恭听。
So if we hear carefully and we don't change anything, we can understand Krishna's pastimes.
如果我们不加增改的小心翼翼的聆听就能明白了。下一个问题是，我们看一下上周三的问题。Jada S 顶拜顾莲花组怎样理解 Krishna 无为而无不为，无为和不为有什么区别？有些糊涂，请Guru举例说明，无限感恩。就 last week, Padmukhi broadcast your lecture on Srimad Bhagavad Gita chapter 4, verse 18. You lectured on Singapore. It's about karma. So this devotee is asking, so how to understand Krishna? So in Taoism, there's a sentence, the kings, the wise kings, they do nothing. They manage the states by following the rules of the nature and they do nothing. So the question is that about what's the difference between do something and they don't do the something. So I think he had some confusion about the Bhagavad Gita and Taoism. So there are different sentences. He is asking how to understand this difference between one do everything and yet at the same time they don't do anything.
Oh yes, right. In the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna explains that, right? Fourth chapter, text 18, right?
Let me see.
That's what he just said, right?
Yes.
I gave class in Singapore on fourth chapter 18. I don't know if it was in Singapore. I think it was maybe in Malaysia.
Okay.
Anyway, I remember speaking on that verse. Lord Krishna said, one who sees action in inaction and inaction in action, then he is a true knower of things.
就是在不加放歌，确实就是在就是Guru 讲不加放歌第四章十节十八译文，于活动中见不活动，于不活动中见活动，这样的人才是人中之智者。虽然他从事种种活动，却已达超然境界。
So he's asking about this, is it?
Yes, he raised the question after the class.
What is the question?
The question is that how to understand Krishna says one does nothing and yet where?
He's doing everything.
Yes.
All right. Well, the point is that a devotee of Krishna is acting on behalf of Lord Krishna. He's not going to get any reactions from his work. There's not going to be any karmic reactions because he's acting on behalf of Krishna. So his work is transcendental, which means there's no reactions.
This 含义就是，就 Krishna 的奉献者们代表 Krishna 而活动， 因此，这些活动不会招致任何业报反应，因为他们是代表 Krishna 而工作的，是超然的，所以不会有任何业报的反应。
But someone else is trying to stop all activities, but they're still going to get reactions because even though they try to stop activities, they will never be successful to stop all activities.Because there will be certain activities which will continue, like breathing and moving and eating. These things you're not going to stop for very long. So you may stop a little while, but still these activities will go on. You may reduce them, but still the activities will go on and there will be reactions because their work is not offered to Krishna.
而另外一些人呢，他们停止试图停止活动，但他们仍然会有反应，因为他们停止活动这是不会成功的。有些人呢，他们必须要呼吸，他们要运动，他们要进食，这些他们试图停止这些活动，但是不可能长时间的停止。他们停止一会儿，但是又会继续。他们可以尽量减少这些活动，但是，他们仍然就是一旦继续的话，他们仍然会有反应，他们的活动仍然会招致反应。
All right, does that answer the question?
Yes, yes. 好，那下一个问题是。如果您还有问题可以继续问，如果没有解释，没有不清楚的话继续问。仆人说灵性知识与超然知识有什么区别？What's the difference between spiritual knowledge and transcendental knowledge?
I also don't know.Well, we see transcendental knowledge is given there, the fourth chapter of the Bhagavad Gita.
在《博伽梵歌》第四章的标题就是超然知识。
So transcendental knowledge. To understand how to get knowledge about the absolute truth.The process. So the fourth chapter of the Bhagavad Gita is not describing Bhakti Yoga, but it's describing transcendental knowledge, describing the process of knowledge. But one may also be impersonalist, may also have transcendental knowledge. Impersonalist can also be transcendental.
第四章呢，就是让人们明白获得绝对真理的，知识和程序。非人格主义者呢，他们也拥有超然的知识，但是这个并不是奉爱的知识。所以第四章并没有谈到 Bhakti Yoga。
Yes, but what he asks about the difference between transcendental knowledge and what else?
韦达经都是超然知识吗？感悟无缘的仁慈。Is Vedas all?
What?
Is Vedas transcendental knowledge?
Well, of course, it's Vedic knowledge. It's coming from, it's eternal knowledge. It comes from the Lord Himself. It's perfect. Yes. But in the Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna says the Vedas deal mainly with the three modes of material nature.
韦达知识是永恒的知识，它来自于主本人，因此它是完美的知识。 但是《国家放歌》中说到，主说到国家，伟大知识主要讨论的是物质自然三形态。
So Lord Krishna said, rise above the modes of nature, become transcendental. You have to understand the Vedas are compiled to give directions for people to live in this world, to live successfully in this world, to enjoy a good life, to achieve economic development, and to have sense gratification, and then ultimately to go on to liberation. That's the Vedas.
伟达经被编纂出来，目的是为了指导在物质世界的人们如何取得成功，过上一种好的生活，取得经济发展，感官享乐，终极而言达到解脱，这是伟达经的题旨。
Okay.
Okay. Shuti Rupa Dasi. Gurde 和老师，聆听今天主在文大文的逍遥故事。我在巴马长寿村感受到大自然最好的阳光、空气、水，也看到人们肆无忌惮破坏环境、污染空气。请问 Guru， 作为 Bhakti 的初级学生，我可以在这里播放圣名，默默无闻的从垃圾捡垃圾开始做风爱服务吗？Dear Guru Maharaj, now I am in
Burma,
yes. They are the best sunshine, best air, and best water. Yet I saw that people are polluting the air and polluting the environment also. So Guru, as the new party in Bhakti, can I broadcast the holy name here and to pick up the rubbish and begin devotional service by picking the rubbish as a devotional service?
Well, I don't know about this. Devotional service is based on hearing and chanting. You have to strengthen the root of your creeper of devotion. I don't know how long you'll be able to keep cleaning the environment of Burma. It's picking up the rubbish and so on. I don't know how long you can be happy doing that.
奉爱服务主要是聆听唱诵，您应该就是强化您的奉爱服务的根基，奉爱服务这个蔓藤的根基，让它扎得非常牢固。我不知道您在那里捡垃圾能够持续多久，会有多么的快乐。
And you're not going to save any souls just by doing that. As a devotee, you should feel compassion for the fallen conditioned souls. And particularly when we think about fallen conditioned souls, we give our attention to the humans. So we want to think how to help the fallen humans there. And
而且就是作为奉献者，他们是非常怜悯那些堕落的贫困灵魂，主要是主要的使命是为了拯救灵魂，所以应该把关注点关注在人类身上，怎样如何帮助那里的堕落的人类，有着人类躯体的人灵魂。
So usually we try to help the conditioned souls by giving the holy name and by giving association, teaching them about Krishna consciousness, how to worship Krishna, and let them read a book about Krishna.
通常我们帮助体困灵魂的办法是给予他们圣名，给予他们联谊，教导他们 Krishna 知觉，教导他们去崇拜 Krishna， 所以您可以让他们去阅读有关于 Krishna 书籍。
So you know there are already some people there who are they've been following Yundun and like that, so they have some knowledge about Krishna, they've heard about Krishna. So you try to give them the real message of Krishna.They heard about Krishna, but they didn't hear from the devotee, because Yundun was not a devotee.
在巴马已经有一些圆顿的追随者们，他们知道 Krishna， 听说了 Krishna， 但因为圆顿本人不是奉献者，所以你要给他们这些人真正的 Krishna 的知识。第二，请孤鲁训示如何在任何情况下保持热情、真诚、谦卑、坚定的奉爱秉持。So Guru, can you give me instruction? How can I keep the devotional quality of being enthusiasm?Being sincere and humble and very fixed.
Well, you have to very... Yeah?
Yes.
So you have to very faithfully chant at least 16 rounds every day without offense. And you have to regularly hear and associate with devotees.
给您的训示就是让您要忠诚的念诵好十六圈，没有冒犯的念诵十六圈，有规律的聆听和与奉献者们去联谊。第三，如何训练自己拥有一双灵性的眼睛，在一切中看到神的存在，把一切都提升为灵性的服务。How can I train myself to have the spiritual vision to see God in every existence and to elevate everything into the devotional spiritual service?
Well, you have to see everything through the eyes of scriptures. You have to become more conscious of everything the scriptures is saying and apply the scriptural knowledge. As you see things with your eyes, you have to see them as they are described in the scriptures.
你应该透过经典去看待一切，并且变得更加有觉知力，把经典加付诸实践，要透过经典的眼睛去看待万事万物。
Just like everyone, the Bhagavad Gita tells us every living entity is a spirit soul. So you have to train your mind to understand all living entities are like your brother and sister. We're all one family under the family of the Supreme Lord.
在《薄伽梵歌》当中就说，众生每一个生物都是灵魂。因此您当训练您的心意， 就把以这种心态，以不加放歌的这种教导去看待一切众生，把他们看成是您的兄弟姐妹，是在至尊主这个大家庭的所有的这个大家庭的家庭成员。哈尔旺萨，Krishna 面对与 Dwarka 皇后们相处有没有压抑呢？压抑了在 Vrindavan 原本的爱的情感，是不是我们相处与人相处也需要压抑与 Krishna 灵性的情感，才能更好的相处呢？Harvansa Prabhu is asking that when Krishna is dealing with the queens in Dwarka, whether or not he has repressed his emotion in the original emotion in Vrindavan, and whether or not should we also depress our emotion in with Krishna so that to better associate with the other person.
Yes, sometimes you may have to do that in order to better associate with another person. You may have to suppress your own ecstatic love for Krishna.
是的，有的时候就为了与另外一个人更好的相处，必须要压抑对 Krishna 的狂喜之爱。
If you don't suppress your love for Krishna, people will think you're a mad person, and no one will have anything to do with you.
倘若您不压抑对 Krishna 的狂喜之爱的话，那人们都会认为你是个疯子，就不会跟你建立任何关系。GND， 请问 Guru 对自己家人的怜悯比别人强烈，这种怜悯是不是还是躯体化概念呢？
No. Go ahead, translate.
He is asking if we have more compassion for our family members than the others, whether or not it is from the bodily conception of life.
Yes, that's the bodily conception of life. You're only thinking of your own family members. You're not thinking of others as your family.
是的，您说的是对的，这个确就是气化概念，因为这样的人只考虑只把自己的家人当成亲人，并没有把其他人也看成是一家人。Gati Prada， 顶拜敬爱的 Guru Maharaj， 圣帕帕说过，我们的哲学是厨房的哲学，节日期间家人朋友都对肉食感兴趣，我做的简单美味的 prasadam 他们都没兴趣，这离圣人的教导相差太远，很惭愧。在这假日我就多念诵和读经典，可以吗？ Obeisance dear Guru Maharaj, Srila Prabhupada said that our philosophy is the philosopher of kitchen.But during the festival, my family members and friends are all interested in meat. My simple and delicious prasadam, they are not interested in prasadam. So that is far away from the expectation of this, his divine grace, Srila Prabhupada. I feel ashamed. So in that case, can I...spend more time in reading and chanting?
Yes, you can spend more time reading and chanting. If they don't appreciate your prasadam, don't waste your time.
嗯，可以，您可以花更多的时间来，就像您说的，阅念诵和读经典。因为人们不欣赏您的 prasadam， 所以那就是浪费时间了。下一 ，the next one， 房 K 2023，顶拜 Guru 和所有奉献者，超然之士是在无依附瑜伽发展出来的吗 ？Obeisance Guru and all devotees is transcendental knowledge developed from Niskam Yoga。That yoga without attachment is transcendental knowledge developed on the level of yoga without attachment.
Well, the process of acquiring transcendental knowledge is to approach the spiritual teacher and to inquire from him.
Mm. 获得超然知识的程序是人们要努力接近一位灵性导师，寻以疑难。
Of course, in the yoga ladder, you're describing Niskam, Niskam Karma Yoga. You're saying yoga without attachment. Yoga without attachment is Niskam Karma Yoga. Yes. So Niskam Karma Yoga is very close to bhakti. It's practically almost like bhakti.
您所说的这个无依附瑜伽范文就是 Niskam Karma Yoga， 那这个已经非常接近 Bhakti Yoga 风爱瑜伽了。
But she's asking is transcendental knowledge? Is it where? Is it above?
Is it developed on the level?
No, in order to do Niskam Karma Yoga, you will have to have transcendental knowledge, because you're not going to develop detachment without transcendental knowledge.
嗯，你要发人一个人要发展起超然知识，那必须，就是您说的这个无依附瑜伽要发展出做无依附瑜伽，那必须得有超然的知识，因为如果没有超然知识的话，一个人是无法达到气觉的。所以下一个就是 Keshava Priya Maharaj Hare Krishna， 顶拜敬爱的 Guru Maharaj， 所有奉献者，有几个问题想询问 Guru 的。一，妈妈专门给我蒸了一些包子，说没有我不吃的材料，让我带着，我带来了，这些包子我要不要吃？So Keshava Priya Maharaj is paying obeisance to Guru and all devotees. She said, my mother made some baozi for me, baozi, steam bread for me. And my mother said, it is pure, without any elements that I don't touch. So should I eat it or not?
Well, if you offer it to Krishna, if you offer it to Krishna, then you can eat it.
倘若您 把这些包子供奉给 Krishna 之后呢，就可以吃了呀。
Of course, your mother is not a devotee, so you know she cooks meat, she cooks non-vegetarian food, so you eat things which she has cooked. There will be some karma there. Now we don't know if Krishna will want to accept what your mother has cooked, because your mother is not a devotee. She doesn't chant Hare Krishna. So she cooked something. She wants you to take it. It's not the best prasadam. But if you want, you know, you can offer it yourself to Krishna and eat it. But it's not the highest, it's not the best quality prasadam. Because your mother is not devotee.
您的母亲她是不是奉献者，然后她也做一些荤食啊，所以这样的食物呢她还是有业报的。但是就是看 Krishna 是不是想要接受她了，因为毕竟您的母亲她不是奉献者，不念 Hare Krishna， 但是她做了这些，就如果您想要把他们供奉给 Krishna 的话，那你可以供奉，但是呢这不是最好的 prasadam， 不是最高品质的 prasadam。
I mean, mama 不是奉献者，你妈妈也吃肉。
您的妈妈因为她不是奉献者，她吃肉。
Of course, your mother loves you and she cooked something for you. So, you can accept it.
但是毕竟您的母亲还是爱自己的孩子，所以您是可以接受的。下一个。
And then you can give it.You can give it to somebody else. Maybe somebody else will eat it.
然后您就可以把这些呢接受了供奉完之后呢就给别人，也许别人会很乐意去吃的。
Yeah, after you offer it to Krishna.
就是您把它供奉完了以后呢再送给别人。在灵修过程中我发现我过往由于愚昧无知犯了很多错误，心意头脑里都是错误，现在改还来得及吗？错的太多，头脑还不清醒，有点不知所措。 So, during the spiritual practice, I found due to ignorance, I made a lot of mistakes, so therefore my mind is full of the mistakes. So if I correct my mistakes, is that okay that I correct my mistakes from now on? Because there are too many mistakes, so I'm not very sober. So I don't know what to deal with those mistakes.
Okay, don't make any more mistakes. Don't keep doing. If you know something was a mistake, you don't want to keep doing the mistakes, right? So go on from now. Don't make the same mistakes again.
过去尽管做了很多错误，那么你就不要再重蹈覆辙了，不要继续犯错误就好了。第三，现在可以做到每天早起3:30就起来念诵，很容易受到躯体痛苦的影响。当我聆听的时候，就意识到是服务；注意到躯体的痛苦的时候，立马就不一样了。心里总是觉得我念不好，心里很泄气。念诵需要3-4个小时，我怎么把从关注自己转变成关注圣名呢？积极的去做服务呢？ Now I can get up at 3:30 in the early morning and begin and do my japa, but I'm easily affected by the bodily pains. When I listen attentively, I realized it is a service. Yet when I put the attention in the bodily pains, my feeling is different. I always felt that I cannot do my japa well. So I'm discouraged. I need 3 to 4 hours doing my japa. So how can I change it from putting the attention in, change my point of attention from bodily pain to the service of the holy name and do my service very enthusiastically?
Well, you have to become more absorbed in the holy name. You have to chant the holy name louder. You have to chant with more attention. You have to stop listening to your mind.
你需要专注地念诵圣名，更高声地去念诵圣名。不要去专注地去听自己的心意。
If you listen to your mind, you'll feel all the bodily pains. But if you chant the holy name and listen to the holy name, you'll forget about all the pains.
如果你去感受那些痛苦，如果你听心意的话，你就会感受到自己这些痛苦。但是，倘若您听聆听圣名的话，就会把他们都忘到脑后了。Chaitanya Charan Das, Hare Krishna, Dimai Guru, Guru, Papa 的说，奉献者应该知道自己位置，不要试图模仿较高层面的奉献者，否则会导致堕落。怎样理解？怎样确定自己的位置？ So, Hare Krishna, Srila Prabhupada said that we should know our position. We don't limited devotee on the higher level.Or else will fall down. How can I understand this sentence? How can I ascertain my position?
Well, we have to understand our position as a servant of Krishna. Understand I'm the servant of the servant. I'm a fallen.Lowly servant. Think of ourself as low and unqualified.
我们应该这样理解，就是我们是 Krishna 的仆人的仆人，是堕落的低贱的仆人。我的地位很低，我没有资格。下一个。
We want to remember also what we were doing before we came to Krishna consciousness, how we were insignificant and we were fallen, we had no good qualities. So now we've come to Krishna consciousness. It doesn't mean that, you know, overnight we've become so different from everybody else.
我们要记住，牢记我们在 进入 Krishna 世界之前的所作所为。我们曾经是那么微不足道，那么堕落，没有资格，没有什么好品质。那现在我们进入 Krishna 世界了，我们就不要指望着一夜之间就变得脱颖而出，与众不同。
We're simply depending on the mercy of Krishna and Prabhupada that he saved us and brought us to this position.
所以我们要依赖 Krishna 的仁慈，依赖圣恩 Prabhupada 的仁慈，他们救了我，把我带到了现在的现有的地位上。
Yes.
Raja Priya, Dimai Guru, 大声的念诵是否也需要压抑？是否需要顾及别的奉献者的感受？ Raja Priya is saying.if I chant very loudly, should I also suppress? Is there also a suppression on my side? Do I also need to take care of the feeling of other devotees?
Yes. We shouldn't be inconsiderate of other devotees. We should also think about other devotees.
是的，就是我们不应该不顾及别的奉献人的感受。
We don't want to disturb other devotees. We want to please them. Our duty is to please the devotees, to be the servant of the devotees. And by pleasing the devotees, then Krishna is pleased.
我们不应当打扰到别的奉献者，相反要取悦奉献者，要成为奉献者的仆人，取悦了奉献者才能够取悦 Krishna。 Harini 顶拜孤对莲花族，请问我在做 Prasada 时边唱诵边做 Prasada， 可是做出来依然不好吃，这意味着 Krishna 并没有接受我的服务，那请问 Gurudev 该怀着怎样心态Krishna 才能接受我做的服务呢？感恩顾对的仁慈。Harini is saying that while I'm doing prasadam, at the same time I also chant, but the food is prasadam is not delicious. So that means Krishna doesn't accept my service. So Gurudev, so in what mood?What should be my mood that Krishna can accept my service?
Well, you have to learn how to cook. If you don't know how to make the food delicious, you have to learn. You have to get help from others. Have some people show you how to cook. Go and learn from people how to cook delicious prasadam.
那就意味着您应该去学习了，因为您做的不好吃嘛，所以您就需要帮助，您就要去学习怎么做出好吃的 prasadam。
You want to please the devotees? We have to have the mood. We want to please Krishna. We want to please his devotees. We want to cook nice prasadam. You have to have that desire. So you have to take some lessons. You have to go and learn from people how to cook or something, how to do it.
我们既然我们想取悦奉献者，我们有这种心态取悦 Krishna 和奉献者的话，那我们就应该，我们应该，既然我们想要做出好吃的 prasadam， 我们有这种愿望的话，那我们就应该向别人学习。
Yeah, we were hearing this morning, somebody said this is, Krishna consciousness is a kitchen religion. And so we have to have nice food. If we are the kitchen religion, if we don't have nice food, something is wrong.
我们刚才在早课时中听到那问题中说到，就 Krishna 之觉是一门厨房的宗教。怎么去做好吃的食物，如果我们没有好吃，拿不出好吃的食物，这意味着肯定出了点什么问题了。下一个Shruti Shri Rupa Kirtida 顶拜 Guru， 看到奉献者明显的问题能否指出来，如何指出来，对方不接受是否是冒犯呢？但因为工作要相处，这样该如何处理呢？ So if I see so obviously the problem on the part of devotee, can I point it out? How can I point it out? If the others don't accept, is it offense? Because of the job.I have to deal with the devotee, so what to do?
Well, you should be very careful about trying to give instructions to others, unless you are their authority. Don't try to give instructions. Don't try to point out faults to others, but simply teach by your own example.
那您就也小心了，就是在指导别人这件事情上一定要特别谨慎，除非您是处在一个权威的位置上，嗯，否则就不要去指导指点别人，去指出别人的错误，相反要用自己的榜样来教导别人。
嗯，你可以。
下一个Atma Vata Devadasi 王文言，顶麦亲爱的 Gurudev 所有奉献者，过年期间我一直在给大家一大家人做饭，他们也都吃，但是这些心意供奉的 Prasadam 会和少量的肉食在一起，可以吗？In the spring festival, I'll cook for a whole family, and they all eat my food. I offered it in my mind, yet there are some a little bit of meat. So, is that okay?
No.
They will eat the prasadam I offered in my mind with a little bit of meat.
No, not okay.
Oh, 不可以。
We don't mix prasadam with meat.
就是我们不会。
Not allowed. We don't allow people to mix, but they have to keep prasadam separate from the meat.
嗯，就是我一个方面呢，就是我们肯定不会。就添加肉食的另外一方面呢，我们也会把普沙能单独和肉食分开的。嗯，肉食吃。I think she's asking whether or not because the table on the table there are普沙能 also there are some meat on other dishes. Maybe she's asking whether.Is that okay?
Well, not very good.
嗯，就是我解释了一下，我想可能是一大桌子，您用心意做的 prasadam， 然后有一小盘一两盘肉食，姑姑说这样不好，也不是很好的。哦，他说，肉食不是我做的，但在同一锅上 ，the meat is not cooked by herself, but it's on the same table.
Yeah. Well, people are going to take the prasadam and they're going to take the meat and mix them together.
那就是他们不管怎么说，他们是一边吃着 prasadam 一边吃肉。
Not very good.
不太好。好。There are two questions more.
Okay.
那我们看最后两个问题。柴欣彤，顶麦亲爱的孤儿奉献者，怎样才能具有强烈的信心呢？信心不足是心意散乱造成的吗？ How can I have strong faith? My faith is not enough. Is that due to my mind is distracted?
Well, you can have strong faith by understanding more the philosophy of Krishna consciousness and by following more strictly all the rules and regulations.And by also taking shelter of Guru Sadhu and Shastra.
您可以更加广泛的去了解 Krishna 制度的哲学，并且严格的遵守规范原则，来拥有足够的信心，并且要脱离于 Guru Sadhu Shastra Guru 圣人和经典。
And you get faith also when you associate with people who have faith. If you associate with people who have good faith, then you will also have developed good faith.
如果您和那些有强烈信心的人联谊，也可以得到强烈的信心。最后一个问题 ,K2023, 请问 Guru, 物质知识靠天赋个人努力获得，灵性知识一个人的品性获得是这样吗？这种品性是什么？ Guru, one get material knowledge by personal endeavor and by his or her natural ability. And what about spiritual knowledge?
Well, we get spiritual knowledge. How do we get spiritual knowledge?
Yes.
Well, we get spiritual knowledge from the spiritual teacher, by inquiring from the spiritual teacher. That's the process of getting spiritual knowledge, by hearing from the spiritual teachers.
灵性知识的获得是通过接近一位灵性导师，聆听他，从而得到灵性的知识。哎呀，one more, two more. 那我们看，现在又有两个问题。胡芳，丈夫家里有亲戚得了绝症，时日无多，但他们没有 Krishna 的知觉，我能做什么呢？ Some relatives of my husband has got serious terminal disease. They don't have Krishna consciousness. What can I do for this person?
Well,you can try to chant Hare Krishna for them.
您可以为他们唱 Hare Krishna.
You can offer them prasadam, see if they will eat it. You can try preaching to them, but may be difficult.
您可以给他们提供 prasadam, 看他们吃不吃。您可以给他们传播 Krishna 这些。但是这有点难。
But you can offer prayers to Krishna to help them in their journey.
但是您可以向 Krishna 供奉祈祷，请求 Krishna 在他们的人生旅途当中帮助他们。
Yeah, we're all on a journey. We come together. You have some family relatives, so they're in your family, and they're on a journey also. They may not be Krishna conscious, but you can pray for them to Krishna to help them.
我们都有各自的人生之旅，那既然大家都凑在一起，成为了亲戚和家人的话，那您可以为他们祈祷，请求主 Krishna 来帮助他们。那个 Atma Vata 我该怎么做呀？我们三口人没有肉食，大家庭做不到。This devotee, she cooked Atma Vata Mataji can ensure that in her own small family there are no meat, but she cannot ensure that in a larger family environment there is no meat on the meat dish on the table. So
yeah.
She is asking what to do.
Well, maybe better she doesn't take anything from the table.
Oh, 那可能对您来说呢，就是您自己 就这一桌上的食物呢，您都不吃，不要碰。
No, you keep your own food separate from their food.
就是您吃的食物，您进到您口中的食物啊，要确保和他们的食物是分开的。
Well, at the same time, be quiet, be respectful, and just tell them you have a special diet.
那与此同时呢，您对他们呢，要非常善意，要有尊敬，就告诉他们您有您自己独特的饮食，您有您自己的食谱。
Okay.
Okay. Oh, yes, she said she will, she had her separate plate. Yes, she did that.
Okay, good.
Oh, she Rupa Kirtida is asking that if the husband and wife are both devotee and whether or not it is offense if they quarrel and attack each other.
Yes.
是，就是冒犯。如果夫妻都是奉献者，
very bad.
那非常糟糕。That's all.
Okay. Thank you, Guru Mani. 我们感谢 Guru Mani 给我们正太的翻译，感谢所有的奉献者。聆听，我们祝福你们春节快乐，传教顺利，万事如意。Hare Krishna, Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai。
Jai。我们非常感谢圣 Bhakti Vignesh Narasimha Maharaj 给我们带来的精彩的早课，感谢Pan Mukhi 的主持，感谢所有奉献者的聆听，祝大家。春节快乐 ，Hare Krishna。
Recording stopped.